Good morning, Darnella.
Good morning.
Are you a little nervous up there?
Yes.
It's understandable. I'm just going to take a few minutes this morning to talk with you and give the jury a chance to hear from you about what you saw, how you reacted, and what happened on May 25th, okay?
Yes.
First of all, Darnella, would you tell us how old you are?
I'm 18 years old.
And 1 week ago, were you 18 years old?
No.
So you just had a birthday?
Yes.
And so when we talk about May 25th of last year, you were?
17.
Are you a student?
Yes.
Tell us, where do you go to, are you in high school?
Yes.
Where do you go to high school?
9th through 11th, I went to Roosevelt High School, then made the decision to switch to Augsburg Fairview Academy for my 12th grade year.
Okay. So you most certainly remember the date of May 25th of last year?
Yes.
I want to take you to a certain time period on May 25th at around 7 o'clock p.m. on May 25th. Do you recall walking to Cup Foods?
Yes.
And were you by yourself?
No.
Were you walking with a cousin of yours?
Yes.
Do you recall how old your cousin was?
Maybe 12, I'm not sure.
Maybe not.
Maybe.
Now you're walking to Cup Foods. Where were you walking from?
Home.
So you live nearby?
Yes.
Would you describe Cup Foods as the neighborhood store?
Yes.
Now the jury may have heard something about this being a dangerous neighborhood. Were you concerned for your safety in walking with your cousin to Cup Foods?
No.
If you had to estimate, how many times would you say you walked to Cup Foods from your home in the neighborhood?
Hundreds, so maybe even thousands.
So you and your cousin walk into Cup Foods. What were you going there for? Do you remember?
I was taking her to get some snacks.
Your cousin loves snacks?
Yes.
So let's go to May 25th of 2020, and I want to show you a couple of things just to set the scene for our discussion. I want to show you what's been marked for identification purposes, for our purposes, as Exhibit 13. Your Honor, I think I need a handler. Okay, I got one. Now, in Exhibit 13, do you see two people in that, in what is a photograph?
Yes, but I also see two people back there. That
awesome.
Counts.
Right, you see two people in the front of the photo and two people in the back.
Yes.
Is this photo a true and accurate depiction of you and your cousin?
Yes.
In the front of the photograph on May 25th?
Yes.
Your Honor, offer Exhibit 13 into evidence.
Any objection? No objection, Your Honor.
13 is received. Would you like me to publish?
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you. All right. Now the jury can see it too. Now this is a screen that you can actually mark on. And so if we see the two people that are right here, in the front of this picture, there's a little girl with the word love on her sweatshirt, and there's another person next to her. One of those persons, you?
Yes.
And which one, the bigger one or the little one?
The bigger one.
And this is your cousin next to you?
Yes.
And is this as you walk into to Cup Foods?
Yes.
I want to show you what we've marked as Exhibit 16. For the trial. If you could pull that up, right? Now, is this the a video that you've seen before?
Yes.
Do you have personal knowledge of the scene that's depicted in this exhibit?
Yes.
Is this video a true and accurate depiction of the scene that you saw on May 25th of 2020?
Yes.
Your Honor, the state offers Exhibit 16 in evidence.
Any objection?
16 is received.
Right. So, Mr. Eltiste, if you could play this a little ways, I want to ask you some questions about it. So we can see with the jury, two people walking from the left to the right. There's a little girl in the green shirt, and there you are. Do you see you?
Yes.
And is this as you all were approaching Cup Foods on May 25th?
Yes.
Now see there, your cousin goes into the store. Why did she go into the store and then you turned around and then came back toward the squad cars?
I wanted to make sure she got in.
You stop there, Brad, for a second. When you walked past the squad car there, did you see anything happening there on the ground as you were walking towards Cup Foods with your cousin?
Yes, I see a man on the ground and I see a cop kneeling down on him.
Was there anything about the scene that you didn't want your cousin to see?
Yes.
And what was that?
A man terrified, scared, begging for his life.
Is that why you directed your cousin to go on into Cup Foods?
Yes.
And then when you saw what was happening there at the scene, what was it about the scene that caused you to come back?
It wasn't right. He was suffering. He was in pain.
Let me stop you there for just a second, Darnella. And so when you say, first of all, he, are you referring to the person you come to know as George Floyd?
Yes.
Did you know anything about Mr. George Floyd before May 25th?
No.
Had you ever met him before?
No.
Ever seen him before, to your knowledge?
No.
So when you came back to this scene here that we can see in Exhibit 16, what did you do when you first got there and we see where you're standing? What did you do?
I pulled out my phone.
And what were you doing to pull out your phone?
Recording, capturing what I was seeing.
And we have already admitted into evidence in this case the video which you had done, which was our Exhibit 15 that's in evidence. So tell the jury what you observed, what you heard when you stopped to look at what was happening there at the scene.
I heard George Floyd saying, I can't breathe, please get off of me. I can't breathe. He cried for his mom. He was in pain. It seemed like he knew. It seemed like he knew it was over for him. He was terrified. He was suffering. This was a cry for help, definitely.
Yeah. You don't disregard any opinions about how Mr. Floyd was feeling, but you can rely on her observations. Mr. Blackwell.
Thank you, Your Honor. Donald, let me show you for a moment. We'll come back to this discussion. Let me show you Exhibit 17. Now, that's also already in evidence. So can you see the person depicted on Exhibit 17?
Yes.
Darnella, are you able to tell the ladies and gentlemen of the jury if you know who this man is? You can take your time.
Yes, yes.
Please tell the ladies and gentlemen, who is this?
This was the officer that was kneeling on George Floyd's neck.
On May 25th?
Yes.
Is this the way he appeared when you saw him on May 25th, kneeling on George Floyd's neck?
Yes.
When you first arrived at the scene, you can take that down, Brett. when you first arrived at the scene and you started recording with your phone camera, were there other bystanders or others there present at the time?
No.
About how long before other people started to gather with you?
Not even a minute in.
And could you estimate roughly how many others were just there around you who were also observing what was happening?
Maybe about 12, 14, something around that, maybe.
If I showed you a picture of those who were there, might you recognize those who might have been present with you? Let's see. Brady, pull up exhibit 184.
Refresh memory, is that correct?
Yes, John, just one moment. Let me make sure it's just that only that she can see.
I've already got it.
All right, thank you, Jeff. As you look at exhibit 184, do these look like in this exhibit the other bystanders who were with you at the scene on May 25th?
Yes.
Your Honor, I'll offer 184 now.
Any objection? No objection. 184.
So looking at this picture, photograph at 184, can you identify for us any of the other bystanders? We know that you identify your cousin to the right. How about any of the people, others here in the photograph?
This is a former friend. This is a friend I went to school with, Alyssa.
Would you just point her out so that we can you can mark on the screen, actually?
Right there.
I'm sorry.
The arrow was on.
I'm sorry, Judge, could you repeat that?
The arrow is on the screen.
The arrow is on
where
the screen.
Where's
your
point?
Yeah, just one moment. Is she able to mark from where she is?
She did. She put the arrow.
She put the arrow on the screen to mark where her friend is. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
You see the arrow, Mr. Blackwell?
Yeah, no, I can't see anything on the screen here at all. All right. You mentioned there's another one of your friends in the picture?
Yes.
And what was the friend's name?
Alyssa.
And could you, again, point out Alyssa? Okay, now I see it. Thank you, Adam. What about any other persons you know here?
Not on the scene, but I do know people that was there at the like, last minute. I know some of the workers because I've lived there for a while.
But you were there the whole time as these various group of bystanders gathered together on May 25th.
Yes.
If somebody were to tell the ladies and gentlemen of this jury that you and the rest of the bystanders who were there were an unruly crowd or mob, I didn't finish the question yet. Hypothetical.
I don't think it could be non-leading. So let's rephrase as a non-leading question, please.
All right. I want you to describe the nature and character of the persons gathered together there. Would you describe yourselves as an unruly mob or an unruly crowd?
Sustain. Now, overruled, I think it's the only way to get an answer is...
However, I would like to sign right
after this answer. Go ahead.
No, I would say everyone were reacting multiple different ways from what they were seeing, which it wasn't right. We all know it wasn't right.
The last part of the answer is stricken. I'd like a sidebar with counsel.
This is Lou Raguse here. They're having another sidebar right now. You heard the objection to the nature of the question, that it was a leading question. Then Judge Cahill allowed it, but said that he wanted a sidebar, and What he's likely doing is explaining to both sides the way that certain questions need to be asked so that there aren't further objections.
Sorry, the technical difficulties are sending shooting pains in all of our ears.
Yes.
Mr. Blackwell, if you would.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you. So as you were there with the other bystanders, did any of these bystanders ever threaten the police?
No.
Did any of them ever physically get violent with the police?
No.
Did you at the scene on May 25th see any violence at the scene at all anywhere?
Yes, from the cops, from Chauvin, and from Officer Tao. I think that's his name.
Other than the violence you saw from Mr. Chauvin and the other police, did you see any act of violence from the bystanders who were there?
No.
Did you see any of the bystanders that act in any way that you would describe as unruly?
No.
Do you think it's fair to call them a mob?
No.
Amongst the bystanders who were there, did you see any of them make an effort to actually offer care for Mr. Floyd?
Physically?
Yes.
I heard them say, "Get off of him. You're hurting him. He can't breathe. He's not moving." But anytime someone tried to get close, they were defensive, so we couldn't even get close.
So first, let's just stick with what you heard the bystanders. The bystanders were saying things to Mr. Chauvin?
Yes.
What things did you hear that were being said to Mr. Chauvin by the bystanders?
"You're hurting him. Are you enjoying this? He can't breathe. He's not moving. His nose is bleeding. You're a bum." Pretty much words around that category.
And when you arrived at the scene, can you describe for us, first of all, what was the position of Mr. Floyd when you arrived at this scene and saw him by the squad car?
He was laid down on the ground, restrained. It didn't look like he could move much but his head.
And by restrained, was he in handcuffs?
Yes.
By restrained, where was Mr. Chauvin in relation to Mr. Floyd?
His knee was kneeling on his neck. It was two other officers holding him down as well.
And what did you hear or see Mr. Floyd doing while he was being restrained underneath, as you described, the knee of Mr. Chauvin?
He was stating that he was in pain. He said his neck, his back, everything hurts. "I can't breathe. Mom," he said, "I would get up if I could," something around that. I wouldn't say that's his exact words. But pretty much he was saying how much in pain he was. He couldn't breathe.
At some point, was there a person who came to the scene who identified herself as a firefighter?
Yes.
Are you able to see her in this exhibit 184?
Yes.
Could you point to her? Okay, and let the record reflect she's pointed to Genevieve Hanson.
She's identified who she believes is the firefighter.
She hasn't testified yet.
The record will reflect that the witness has identified the person in dressed in black, holding up a phone with a white headband in Exhibit 184.
When this person who identified herself as a firefighter came, what did she do?
She asked them to check his pulse.
Who did she ask to check?
Chauvin.
And she asked Officer Chauvin to check the pulse of Mr. Floyd?
Yes.
Then what happened?
He remained kneeling on his neck. And she asked multiple times, not just once.
Then what did she do? Did she try to check his pulse?
No, they wouldn't even let us get close.
And what prevented your getting close when you say they wouldn't let us get close?
They were quick to pull out mace.
Who pulled out mace?
Officer Tao and Chauvin. He put his hand on his mace. They put their hand on their mace. I can't remember if they actually pointed at us, but they definitely put their hand on the mace and we all backed back.
Did you feel threatened by the police officers?
Yes.
Did you feel threatened by Mr. Schott?
Yes.
Why is that?
He seemed like, how do I word this? I felt like I was in danger when he did that. It rubbed me the wrong way. I didn't understand why they would do that, what we did for them to make them do that. That's why I felt threatened. I don't understand why the mace was even needed at all.
So as you were observing Mr. Floyd under the knee of Mr. Chauvin, did you ever see Mr. Chauvin do anything to offer care to Mr. Floyd?
No.
Did he ever either let up or get up so that he could breathe?
No.
Did you ever see him try to administer CPR?
No.
Did you see him call anyone else to administer aid to Mr. Floyd?
No.
Did he call out and ask if anybody amongst the bystanders knew CPR who might be able to help him?
Not at all.
At what point did you see, well, let me ask this. Did an ambulance at some point arrive at the scene?
Yes.
And you saw the ambulance arrive there?
Yes.
Roughly how many minutes after you first started watching what was happening to Mr. Floyd did the ambulance show up?
The end of my video, the video was about 10 minutes. I would say maybe somewhere around 9. I'm not sure.
So was there any point in your video, whether it's 9 or 10 minutes, that Mr. Chauvin ever let up or got up off of the neck of Mr. Floyd that you saw?
No. If anything, he actually was kneeling harder. It looked like he was shoving his knee in his neck. Like he was, yeah.
So was it your experience then, as the bystanders cried out, that Mr. Chauvin kneeled in even harder? Is that what you're saying?
Can you rephrase that?
You told us that it looked like Mr. Chauvin was kneeling in even harder.
Yes.
On Mr. Floyd. Was there anything that was in response to that he was kneeling harder?
I feel like he was feeding off of our energy.
Calls for speculation.
I want to know.
Should we take our morning break at this time?
Yes, sir.